Hi, Jim Pancero, helping you become a stronger leader of your sales team, especially in these virus impacted times. One of the realities of our process now is the virus and sequestering everybody has dramatically changed how the buying process is working, how buyers are buying, and how we need to sell them. One of the ways I describe the selling process is that really the structures of selling don't change, but they just expand or contract, kind of like an accordion that you can pull it out to a longer selling process, or it could be shortened to even a one-call sale. Well, the reality of our process of this latest impact of the virus on our selling is that the whole accordion has compacted. We have less time to do things. We have less opportunities on site to talk to customers. It's a more distant learning selling process that we're now involved in. So because of that, structures have changed. We need to look at how we realign our selling skills. Just the same as if you took a salesperson from out of their territory off of the street that was out calling on larger customers and you put them in your retail store, you'd have to change the accordion because the selling process is now significantly shortened. How do we still make that salesperson persuasive even under these new selling environments? Well, the same contraction has happened because of the virus. So now the question as a manager is, how are you helping your team realign and refocus to reset their accordion, the space of what they need and how the time they have to do things? How are we realigning it to make sure your salespeople continue having maximum persuasiveness and impact on their customers? We're out of this process is we need to look at these skills. We just can't say sell faster or sell shorter. We've got to understand and explain how they do it. See, there's four levels of selling skills your salespeople need to be successful. And success in selling comes when they master all four. The bottom level, the first, the foundation of all selling, is having strong attitude and energy. Strong work ethic, ethical, professional, committed, interested, curious, all these things are attitudes, all positive to selling. The second level up, though, above the foundation of selling, is your personal skills, your operational skills. Your knowledge of the steps of a sales call is an operational skill. How to answer questions, how to close, how to qualify are all operational skills. Any product, industry, or customer knowledge is also operational because it all makes you personally persuasive because of these knowledges and skills. The third level, though, is your tactical skills, and this is where it starts to get a little verified error. A lot of salespeople don't do too much in here. They only think one move ahead and just do what's next best needs to be done. But the tactical process is when you can think and plan multiple moves ahead, having more of a plan of attack than just attacking. The idea of how many moves ahead are your people thinking? What are the steps of your process? Structures like, what is your identify to close selling process for a new account? What is your process from January 1st to December 31st to support and maintain some of your best customers? What is your tactical plan to get higher, wider, and deeper to make sure you have the most stable accounts that you're selling to? These are all tactical controls, and these are all controls that need to be adjusted now that the selling processes have changed. The fourth and final skill has always been strategic. What is your philosophy, your positioning, your differentiation? How are you answering a customer when they say, why, based on all the competitive alternatives available to me, do I want to buy from you? That's going to be a strategic answer of your philosophy or your approach. The challenge I watch in selling is most salespeople are really strong with their attitude and energy, and they're not doing too bad with their technical industry knowledge and their knowledge of their customers and their ability to be persuasive on their feet. They have the operational skills under control. It's the tactics and strategy that are weak for most salespeople, and this is where we need you as a manager stepping in. How are you helping your people readjust and understand and think more moves ahead now that we're in a different tactical structure of selling because of this post-COVID virus environment that we're in now? Would love to know how you've adjusted your selling processes. Love to know how you're helping your team achieve this. And as always, thanks for watching.